Hello students, in this video we are going to discuss the idle time wage, treatment of idle time wage in cost accounts and control of idle time wage or control of idle time. In the first video of idle time wage, we have already discussed the concepts of idle time and idle time wage, the causes of idle time and classification of idle time. Now let's start. Treatment of idle time. To understand the treatment of idle time in cost account, you must understand the classification and causes of idle time. So, as we have already discussed in video 1, if the idle time is normal in nature plus controllable in nature, we know that idle time can be normal, controllable, normal, uncontrollable. So, if it is normal and controllable in nature, it should be included in factory overhead. Second, if it is normal plus uncontrollable in nature, it should be included in prime cost. And if it is abnormal idle time, then it should be charged to costing PL. So these are the three possible treatments. Now let's discuss a little bit. Normal idle time, that means we have already discussed in video 1. Normal idle time means those idle time which are caused from normal activities of the concern. And we know that some normal idle time are controllable in nature, some are uncontrollable in nature. For example, the idle time arising from the breakdown of machinery can be reduced to some extent by improving the repairing part or regular maintenance part. So if the idle time has arose from the normal activities of the concern, it is called normal idle time. So out of the normal idle time, if it is controllable in nature, then it should be included in factory overhead. But if it is uncontrollable in nature, for example, we know that even if we try to reduce accidents, it is not possible to eliminate the possibility of accidents completely. Then the time lost due to tiffin, tea breaks, etc. of workers, these are normal in nature. These are definite reasons of idle time. These are normal, but these are uncontrollable. That means it cannot be completely reduced or minimized even after adoption of all possible measures. So if it is normal plus uncontrollable in nature, in that case it should be included in prime cost by increasing wage rate. Now by increasing wage rate means how is it done? Let us take an example. Suppose out of a 12 hour working day, 2 hours are lost due to idle time. Hourly wage rate is rupees 20, then the total wage for the day will be 20 rupees into 12 hours, that is 240 rupees for a worker. Now if the idle time has been caused due to normal but uncontrollable reasons like tool setting, tea breaks, etc., we know that these cannot be completely eliminated. These cannot be controlled completely. That's why these are uncontrollable but normal in nature. So if this 2 hour is lost due to tool setting, tea breaks, etc., these type of reasons, then wage rate is to be increased by rupees 4 per hour. How is it calculated? Rupees 240, that is total wage, divided by effective hour of work or productive hour of work, that is 10. So here it will give you 24 rupees. That means wage rate has been increased from 20 to 24 because the organization knows every day or in normal activities these 2 hours will be lost because it is uncontrollable in nature. I have to pay 240 rupees, but for 12 hours the worker is working, but I will get production of 10 hours only. So in this case, through the production of 10 hours, we have to recover the cost of 12 hours. So in this case, rupees 24 will be the inflated wage rate or new wage rate, which will be charged to different jobs as a part of prime cost by increasing the wage rate. So the organization will charge to production of 10 hours 240 rupees in this way so that it can recover 240 rupees through the production of 10 hours because it is normal, it is uncontrollable in nature. Clear? Now the third and last treatment that is possible, abnormal idle time. Now, abnormal idle time we have already discussed in video 1 that can also be controllable and uncontrollable. But in any case, the abnormal idle time should be charged to the wage from abnormal idle time should be charged to costing profit and loss account. It should not be charged to the product or should not be charged to the job or to the customer. It should be charged to the costing profit and loss account and the organization has to bear the cost. So we have already discussed also in overtime wage video that abnormal nature of losses should be cost which should be charged to costing PL always. Clear? Now, what are the controlling measures of idle time? Controlling measures of idle time may be production planning should be done properly. That means the production planning and procedure are to be carefully designed well in advance and proper organization is to be made for it. The task of supervision should be tightened. That means the supervision should be done strictly. Otherwise, the workers may take more breaks. It will increase in overtime. So, if I do the supervision properly, then it will reduce the idle time portion. Similarly, production planning is done properly. The workers do not have to wait for the instruction or the supply from other departments. So, it will reduce the overtime. It will reduce the idle time portion. Then, routine checkup of machinery should be done to ensure or to avoid breakdown. So routine checkup will reduce breakdown, it will reduce idle time. Uninterrupted power supply should be ensured. Now power supply, alternative power supply mechanism can be developed, like some battery backup or generator backup can be developed, or power station or small power generation unit can be developed within the organization, so that in case of power failure, uninterrupted power supply can be ensured. Uninterrupted supply of raw material should be ensured. If raw material supply is interrupted, that will create idle time for the workers. So if supplier is not reliable or he is failing in some cases to supply materials in time, so in that case I can develop some alternative sources of raw materials so that it can be uninterruptedly supplied to the production process. Then production of more than one seasonal product. If my product is of seasonal nature, in this case in off season time idle time increases because the production or demand decreases, so idle time increases in off season time. So if I can develop some alternative seasonal product, in that case in off season I can develop some other product. So in this case the idle time can also be reduced. Better employee management relationship should be developed to avoid loss of time due to strike, lockout, etc. So employee management relation, if it can be properly managed by the management or administration, then definitely loss of time due to strike, lockout can be reduced, which will definitely reduce the idle time. So these are some of the major controlling measures of idle time. So in this video I hope you have understood two major things that is very much important for your costing related examinations. One is treatment of idle time in cost accounting, another is controlling measures of idle time. So thank you very much.